Welcome to the Transform Our World podcast with Ed Silvoso. Ecclesia, everyone, every day, everywhere.
Hello, my friends. This is Ed Silvoso with Transform Our World. And this is about changing the spiritual climate. First, in our lives, for us to know who we really are in Christ. And then to hear the voice of God, to receive the power for the gates of Hades to be defeated. In this podcast, I'm interviewing people that are experiencing that. They realize I am the church. I am the ecclesia. Every day, everywhere, every place. Yes, that is the ecclesia. And I'll tell you, we read in the Bible fascinating testimonies. Because they are inspired by the Holy Spirit, they inspire us. But often there is a gap, and we wonder, can that happen today? Well, fasten your seatbelt. I am so honored, so blessed to have as our guests, Salome and Leon Roat. These are marketplace ministers, people that God is using mightily to bring the presence, the power of God. In fact, they have come to love Mondays as much as they love Sundays. Because when the church meeting ends on Sunday, church continues to go on because they are the ecclesia. Salome and Leon, welcome to this podcast.
Thank you. Thank you, Ed. Thanks for having a chance to talk with you over this podcast.
And Salome, you are originally from Latin America. Tell us a little bit about that. Tell us about that.
Well, I married this wonderful man that actually 33 years ago. And of course, I was born in Quito, Ecuador. And God brought him, and I bring Leon to this always because God had a plan. And even though I was born in Quito, Ecuador, he brought me to the Bay Area. Yes. And yet, God is moving in Ecuador. The ecclesia is moving in Ecuador. God has put in our hearts from the very beginning of our marriage to be the ecclesia. And like you're saying, the ecclesia is everyone. It's for everyone. So it started in ourselves, in our lives. And God has such a plan in our lives. God has, you're asking me, tell me a little bit about Ecuador and how that happened. That's the
thing. You were born there and the Lord transplanted you here through a very romantic connection with this handsome man who went.
Too kind.
but you know what is so appealing to me about this interview? Both of you are walking with the Lord. Both of you are in ministry. You have launched a ministry. I want you to tell a little bit about that. And even though you are successful and doing well, when you heard about transformation and the ecclesia, that helped you move things up a little bit, right? If I'm correct, tell us about it.
Definitely. When we started our walk with the Lord, he put in our hearts to always be in community. We felt that the ecclesia was already, you know, spoken to our hearts. Mm. And it was really after we met you, Ed, and through the conferences that we went and reading your material. And thank you so much because you and Ruth are such an inspiration to our lives. God has used us in such a way to really understand what the ecclesia is, what transformation is. So for us, Leon and I, we started doing small groups early in our marriage. That was like one of the things that we just wanted to do. God put in our heart to have this community to assemble, with others and to ask the Lord Jesus, his presence, you know, come and just fill us up with more of you, Jesus. So we did that. Even before we got married. So we knew that this is what God wanted in our lives, but it was later than this was really explained well to us that it was, you know, that we understood that the ecclesia was the assembly, this Greek word that you talk in your book about, and that this is something that we wanted to do. So all of our lives, I think that we have been, doing the ecclesia. I'm sorry, I may have to pause my voices.
So you began always with the small groups because you want people to be built up. You launch a ministry called, give us the name, Becoming the One.
So, Salome wrote a book called Becoming the One.
Yeah.
You are featured there prominently in chapter 16 about the transformation of what a transformational marriage could be. And so it's about training singles before they even think about getting married to get them so that they love God. The three pillars are of becoming the one are that they love God, that they understand their identity. We talked about that. That's part of the accelerator. I'm talking about who your identity is in Christ. And then receiving the healing that they need before they go into marriage to receive that. And so we've always been about small groups and the way that we do ecclesias. Well, we have a leadership team. We consider that an ecclesia. We also, Cathedral of Faith has really embraced what we're doing. We have Becoming the One groups going there. We're going to be doing a conference, which you're going to be speaking at. Sorry to give you these shameless plugs at, about
And our granddaughter, too. I understand one of our granddaughters is on a panel, isn't she?
Yes, she's gonna be on the panel. She actually works as part of BTO. She's part of the marketing marketing,
if you call it
that. Social media and that type of thing. But it is about developing community, and the BTO groups are ecclesias, each one. So I know you had the vision of a million or billion ecclesias or something like that. But anyway, we've really taken it to heart. What Transform Our World is kind of sewed into our ministry is to have these groups and then have those groups birth other groups and then become apostolic and really, again, a lot of it, formatted on a lot of.
What really, really blesses me, Leon and Salome, is that God has used you to form groups, to train people, to equip them. But you said, but that is not the end. The end is to transform the world, beginning with the individual and with marriage, right? That's why Becoming the One, that's your book that I strongly recommend. And so you are a forerunner for ministries that do not become the end of the ministry, but the means to a higher thing, right? But let me ask you this, Salome. When people took the accelerator, how did that impact them? What fruit did you see when people take the accelerator?
Well, the first time that we did it and we left this group, you saw some really beautiful stories because people wanted to do it again. So like Ian was telling you, we want to move apostolically. So whatever the Lord Jesus does in their hearts, we tell them, go ahead and do it. I mean, that's the Ecclesia Accelerator. We are in the family ministry. And I love the session 7. We talk a lot about family. That's how, I feel like the people that receive this, they just want to bless other people relationally. Yeah. They want to see other marriages being transformed. They want to see singles, walking in the ways of the Lord and really say, hey, we're going to really teach, equip you to do things in a godly way. And that is so beautiful because, see, when we think about prayer evangelism, we're like, this is what our leaders are learning. Yeah. We pray, we go to the Lord before And we ask him, give us these people, give us your children, Lord, their loves, come, bring them to us. And then their needs are the relational, they don't know how to do relationships.
And you mentioned lesson number 7. I'm very partial to that one because my wife speaks there, right? And like you too, she says the ecclesia begins in the home, right? I have watched that session time and again, and then I have read your book, and we are so blessed that you put that emphasis on families, because here in the Bay Area, we need to see restoration in families, right? But let me ask Leon a couple of questions. Leon, you are a financial planner, and you will not say this, but I know you are very successful. You have a vast portfolio. How have these impacted you and your family? Because I understand some of your kids are working with you, more than working, ministering with you. Tell us about it.
So, I've been a financial advisor for 31 plus years, and thank you for your kind words. And you know, I've been successful. I'm not saying that in a bragging way. You know, thank you God for every. We understand that everything that He gives to us is to be, is to be stewarded for His kingdom, and that's why, you know, one of the things we support, you know, transform our world in. But I'm still working on the vision for, I do the prayer walking. I think I've told you that before. You know, we do the prayer walking, the buildings that I'm in. I'm still waiting for God to do, you know, some amazing things with that. But I always want to incorporate the love and the care with my clients. And, you know, my daughter Amy works with me full time. I was trying to hire my daughter Jessica. That's still a work in progress. One of the visions I do have in the future is to hire somebody that will go to underprivileged schools and teach financial literacy, for no better word, as well as how to handle money and things like that. So we can do, you know, what Transform Our World's talking about, which is change, you know, intergenerational poverty.
Well, but hold it there. Look at that. I want the audience to capture this. Here we have a successful financial planner who says, I prayer walk the building. You speak blessings over the building. You are seeking God to minister to your clients. I'm sure if time were to allow, you will have stories, right, where people felt better coming to see you. They felt a presence. Now you are training your daughter to be an associate minister, and you're thinking of going to underprivileged schools. That is transformation, Leon.
Yeah. Well, I mean, and again, that's still a vision, but you know, part of that was, you know, you keep having this prophetic word over me that I'm going to help eradicate systemic poverty.
Yes.
And,
yeah.
You know, it's great. You know, we've been blessed. God has blessed us more beyond our dreams than we can even imagine. But now, you know, how can we transfer that to transform a society? And I know that's only one of the pillars, because only their financial needs are only that's only meeting a temporary need. Their need is to feel the manifest presence of Jesus in their lives, to know Him, because that's the bread of life that they're never going to continue to hunger with.
Well, you know, Ruth, my wife and I have had the privilege to be in your home more than once. And like our home, your home is a temple to the ecclesia, right? The presence of God is all over the place. So what would you say to the audience about, number one, taking the presence to the workplace, and celebrating the presence in the home? Just briefly, speak a word to the audience.
Yeah, so I just say, when you come in contact with somebody where two or more are gathered in His name, they're the ecclesia. When you're ministering to the least of these, and it's not about trying to get them saved and give them the four spiritual laws, but it's just love on them. Like Ed, you're talking in your book, you know, love on them first. Eat with them first, and then let God take it from there, and then you're able to share about Jesus. But they'll see the love when they come into our house. We just try to be giving. You know, it's like whatever food you want, go for it. You don't want it right in the refrigerator, great. You know, that type of thing. But be inviters and includers into your home, and that's the way to really spread God's love to our
society. Know, Beverly Hyme, who used to be an associate pastor at Cathedral, she defined prayer evangelism that comes out of Luke 10 in a brilliant way. It's talking to God about the lost. before we talk to the lost about God, right? And that's what you do over your portfolio, right? You pray for them, even though they don't know you are praying. Salome, you are doing that with the young people that you and Leon are training and seeing you by example. You love each other, you know, and you and your kids are walking with the Lord. So I wonder if one of you could have a word of impartation on the audience. Would you do that now, please?
Can I just say something that I feel God is leading us to say? And it's how, you know, the beauty of a couple that loves Jesus. And think about the marketplace, how Leon is doing that. So yes, he's been doing all these prayer walks. He prays for his clients. We bring the presence of Jesus wherever we go, every day, everywhere, right? And here at home, the two of us, I just feel that favor. Someone else was speaking more about that, you know, more favor of the Lord in our lives and how to open up the presence of Jesus at home. Yeah. Like you've been teaching us, like what his word says, do that every day. So to walk in that way as a couple, you know, the Lord wants marriage to be so strong. That's what I feel, you know, that's the calling. So the impartation that I feel like the Lord is saying is, you know, hold on to Jesus, invite his presence in your home. That's the first ecclesia. That's the first, you know, in your home. Yeah. It starts, you know, with husband and wife. And then, you know, just go and bless. Pray about, you know, the everyone around you, your circle of influence. In our case, God has given us a lot of people that are in this need of, you know, help us to know how God wants us to relate to each other, to have a successful marriage. Everyone has a calling. Everyone needs to know, you know, how to work in our gifts that God has given us. So the impartation is, you know, let's be together. Let's be one. Let's have this love that only God can give us. And let's have this love as a, you know, God says that he wants us to have the heart of a child, this innocence, this trust, you know, that we can just receive so much from the Lord and trust that he will do all these things and have his favor and move in that way. And that has been such a blessing. And thank you for the encouragement to Leon and I, because that's the transformation, you know, that we've seen in us, in our family, in the sphere of influence. And we just bless everyone with knowing, you know, just that God has so much love and favor, and that we do this also in community. That's the ecclesia. And that we can go and just impart it everywhere, that love, those blessings, and just serve.
What you just described is ecclesia, everyone, every day, everywhere, but beginning in the home. And so this is your assignment, audience. Take Revelation 3:20 for what it is. The Lord is at the door of your house, and he's knocking, and he's saying, if you hear my voice and open the door, I will come in. Invite the Lord into your home like Salome and Leon have done, the way Ruth and I did it. And I'll tell you, it changes everything. Jesus came across some funeral services and turned them into a fest. And that's what the Lord will do. May the Lord bless you. Go to our website, transformourworld.org, and you will learn there about the material, including Salome and Leon's book, Becoming the One, that we strongly recommend. God bless you. And until the next program.
Thank you for listening to today's edition of the Transform Our World podcast with Ed Silvoso. Ecclesia, everyone, every day, everywhere. We invite you to make your own home in Ecclesia, a place where the presence and power of the Lord Jesus dwells every day. Then visit us at transformourworld.org or Ecclesia Everywhere on Facebook to join a massive movement of believers who are changing our world for the better. Because it really is God's time for you, your family, your neighborhood, and nation.